Gold miners ravaged this section of the John Day River's Middle Fork decades ago, and today the land, water, and fish still suffer.
And this property's been recovering from that, you know, 4 or 5 years of dredging operation ever since.
Leading the effort to restore what's known now as the Oxbow Conservation Area is Brian Cochran, a restoration ecologist with the Confederated Tribes of Warm Springs.
You know, this is definitely one of the most degraded sections of the Middle Fork John Day River. And yet, we feel this is one of the most important projects in the John Day Basin just because of the critical habitat that is here from the fish.
While fish still spawn in this section of the John Day, a low percentage of their young thrive well enough to endure a journey to the ocean. The river lacks deep pools, cool water, and adequate cover for small fish.
And we feel if we increase rearing habitat, we'll have more fish going out, which means more fish coming back.
Around 1939, miners straightened the Middle Fork's riverbed, dredged out a new channel, and ripped up critical riparian zones, destroying the floodplain. Today, about 100 acres of mine tailings litter the banks of the river, impacting the habitat of Chinook salmon, steelhead, and bull trout.
This was dredged into place. It's not a natural channel. It was dredged in as part of the operation of dredging all the gold.
On a recent tour, representatives of the many agencies and organizations supporting the project got a glimpse of the first phase and its progress. Elaine Eisenbraun of the North Fork John Day Watershed Council is excited to think that one day this section of the river will be restored.
I hope to see a functioning hydrology, and I think that's what they're trying to obtain. A web of resources that are all working together.
So far, workers have planted about 14,000 native shrubs and trees along the original river channel. Under phases 2 and 3, crews will fill in the north channel created by mining, bring in whole trees with attached root wads to create structures that scour pools, and re-meander the river where it was straightened some 70 years ago.
Right behind me is the North Fork. Or the north channel of the Oxbow, and this is what we're trying to fix.
Bonneville Power Fish and Wildlife Administrator Jason Karnezis says in addition to paying for the property purchase back in 2001, BPA now continues to fund the project through the Columbia Basin Fish Accords. He says the thousands of cubic yards of mine tailings now littering the river's banks will be used in the restoration of the Middle Fork John Day.
Some of this is actually going to be used to plug up the channel again. Some of it's going to be used to recontour a new channel.
All the work is a critical link to the miles of protection, restoration, and land management that has occurred in the upper Middle Fork John Day Valley. Once the project is complete, scientists believe great numbers of salmon and steelhead will once again fill up this section of the river, making the upper Middle Fork among the best fish habitat in the entire John Day Basin.
I mean, I'm a sportsman as well, and I would love to see huge numbers of Chinook. And since we're limited on rearing habitat and we're creating that habitat with this project, hopefully one day we'll see that.